In contrast to the hydrophilic hormones, which cannot enter a cell and therefore must bind a membrane-bound receptor to initiate a cellular response, the lipophilic hormones shown here can actually enter the cell, right? Because they're lipophilic, they can diffuse through the lipid bilayer and enter the cell. But they tend to bind receptors that are found either in the cytoplasm or in the nucleus. Now, on the left here, let's look at the steroid hormones for a moment. Steroid hormones tend to enter the cell and bind receptors that are initially stabilized by what are referred to as chaperone proteins. And these chaperone proteins basically inhibit the receptor from activating the cellular response prior to actually binding the hormone. Once the hormone binds to the binding site on that receptor, the chaperones dissociate, and then it can actually diffuse into, or the receptor could actually be in the nucleus already. But once we're bound and we have what's called a hormone receptor complex, the two stuck together, those two will actually bind to a transcription modifying region of DNA known as the hormone responsive element, or HRE. And what that does, once we bind the hormone receptor complex to that region, we activate that segment of DNA to be transcribed and translated into functional proteins. And so the response to our steroid hormones is to produce new more proteins that are already being produced to modify the structure and or function of this particular cell. Now, the thyroid hormones act in similar fashion, but so slight differences. The thyroid hormones actually, they will diffuse into the cell to a degree, but they're not quite as lipophilic. And so they actually get a little bit of help from a membrane transport protein to enter the cell. Now, once in the cell, the thyroid hormones tend to bind receptors that are already bound to the HRE. So these receptors are already sitting there waiting for the thyroid hormone to arrive. Now, once we bind our hormone to that receptor site, we are once again going to activate transcription and translation, of course, modifying a protein expression of that cell and the functionality or the structure of that cell. Now, we also have to be able to diminish the response to steroid or thyroid hormones. And so, once again, we can, of course, have enzymatic degradation of these hormone molecules, and that'll, of course, remove the stimulus. But we haven't really removed the response, right? Our change in protein expression. And so for that, we actually usually have to wait for protein turnover, where we get degradation of these proteins over time. And then if our stimulus is no longer present, our thyroid or our steroid hormones aren't present, we just won't replace these proteins, and the cellular response will dissipate over time.